Color guard can be defined as the visual aspect of the band. It can also be defined as a team of individuals coming together to create something special. The Florida State University's Marching Chiefs Color Guard is an example of an outdoor guard. Nicole Lahneman is a senior at FSU and is captain of the Color Guard. She has been doing color guard for 8 years.
Someone that's going to do color guard needs to be very coordinated and have the willingness to learn a new skill.
Emily Stonecipher is a junior at FSU. She's been doing color guard for 4 years.
I really enjoy being able to have individuality with my spinning, but at the same time, I'm in a cohesive unit. So it's really fun to be part of a team and still get to do stuff with other people.
There are two parts to a flag, the silk and the pole. The silk provides the color for the show, while the pole is how every movement is managed.
Color guard can be an indoor or an outdoor sport. Outdoor color guard consists of working with a marching band, while indoor color guard is a competitive circuit, also known as winter guard. Cimarron Independent Guard is an indoor winter guard.
This will be year two for Cimarron Independent Winter Guard. We are based here in Tallahassee, Florida. A couple of us decided to put the guard together last fall. I think winter guard gave me a family when I needed it. It kept me active.
Winter guard has competitions just like cheerleading, gymnastics, or dance. Indoor color guard, or winter guard, incorporates more dancing in the work than outdoor color guard.
Winter guard is so much more personal. Mm-hmm. Your coaches are watching everything you're doing. They're helping you. You get more attention.
The band would probably just look a little bland without our visuals. The flags definitely add that extra pop that they're looking for.
My favorite part of winter guard would have to be the performing. Mm-hmm. The feeling you get when the crowd hushes or they applaud.
For FSU, I'm Linda Kelsey. Now,